Hello and welcome to the course of Elements of Mechanical Engineering. In this video, an attempt is made to understand the basics of this solar energy. And we know that solar energy is a renewable energy source. Okay? Yes. Renewable sources, solar. You know, abundantly available. So, sun, somewhere a solar plates to collect, and we convert this solar energy into electrical energy. So what is it? It's a energy from the sun. How much left? Endless. We don't know how much. Advantage. No pollution and can be used in any remote areas. Right? And disadvantage. Yes, we know. If there are advantages, we do have some disadvantages. Mainly, it is expensive and need exactly a sunlight. And at night, it doesn't work. Okay. Now, try to understand this. How does it happen? This photovoltaic. The photovoltaic is the one which converts the solar energy into electrical energy. So, for photovoltaic generation, this is a small sketch of how to represent this, how to know this. So, one layer would have an N-type semiconductor. Okay. Another one would be again a P-type semiconductor. So, in between these two, right? In between these two, N-type and a P-type semiconductor, we do have a zone. The zone is said as depletion zone. Okay. So whenever I do have, you know that these are semiconductor plates, right? Whenever a solar rays fall on this, so this four solar rays do have a photon. It falls over the semiconductor material, where it calls a silicon material. So whenever the photon falls on this, the electron will be ignited. And this electrons flow through the circuit and produce the electricity. A very concept behind this. Okay. Now, one by one, let's answer. The photovoltaic cell is a device, as I said, that which converts solar energy into electrical energy by the photoelectric effect. The what is the photoelectric effect? As we discussed earlier, the photons in the sunlight hits the solar panel that are absorbed by the semiconducting materials, again, which is said as in a silicon. Okay? And when the electrons are knocked out, their atoms, allowing them to flow through the circuit, and the electricity is being produced by them. Very simple as it is. And we do have the complementary charges that are also be created, which are set as in holes and flows in opposite direction in a silicon solar panel. Okay. And the array of solar panel converts the solar energy into a usable amount of electric current, that we call as a direct current, DC. DC is the kind of what we get from this energy. Okay. So now this is how it happens. If I had a sunlight falls over this silicon material, right? Silicon materials, then the atoms have been ignited, and since we do have a flow of electron over there, you can see the charge over here. No sunlight, nothing like a photon being fall over the silicon material, nothing like ignition of the igniting of an electrons from a surface, and therefore no current flow, nothing happens over here. No sunlight, no electricity, no electron feed. Sunlight, yes, electron feeds do come into existence. Next very important consideration is to find or to know what is this flat plate collector. You could have seen this or you could have witnessed this in your home. At the top of your home, you would have a solar panel which gives you out a warm water or a hot water. So how this happens? This works out with a very simple concept behind. As you could see over here, you would have one flat plate collector like this or like this. So which would have ample of tubes, and from tube would have a water flow flowing through these tubes. Right? Would have water flow flowing through these tubes. Whenever the sunlight falls over this, we would have a reflector plate at the bottom of this plates, where the sunlight will be reflected back to the tubes and heat will be passed to the tube, and this water, whatever the flows in through it, will get heated up and will stored into a tank, and that is be used for a specific use or a purpose. Okay. So some of the what happens with the solar plate is a heating system designed to capture the heat, one, and the solar pan are constructed within tubes and then flat plates. And these are the absorbers which draw heat from a sun and transfer it to a pipes which had a cold water in it. Okay. So usually this water then runs through the heating system either actively or passively. If I say actively using a pump or passively using would be a fall of a gravity. Now some we do have a solar parabolic collector, as you could see over here. The whole parabolic collector moves or track to the as the sun movement, as you could see here. The maximum efficiency can be utilized from this. As you could, all the way the direction has been pumped back to this single concentrator, what we had. So this is a sort of example we call as a parabolic solar plate collectors. So some video I have again where some other specifications where I can use the heat over here in order to generate a water into a steam that can be steam over flown over to the turbines and turbine to generate a power. Not only a steam is used to produce electricity, even the steam is used to cook a food also. As we could see, witness in many places we do use a steam that has been generated from a solar to cook a rice at a maximum constant or extent. So this is another example. You see all these parabolic collectors has been collecting a ray and been transmitting at single point where the heat has been transmitted to then a boiler where the water or hot water is used for specific concern or for application. One more parabolic collector somewhere looks like this, and this is a solar parabolic collector where the mirror surface of reflector, the sunlight into receiver and heat up a liquid which has been passing through this pipe. Okay. And this solar collector that which is in the form of a curved reflector covers a large area. That's why we made this whole collector into a curved surface. Okay. And steam is piped into or outside the turbine to produce electricity in order to have an electric generation, or somewhere the heat is being produced sent to a boiler where the hot water can be used for specific or another reason. Okay. Other sort of like solar energy where we use, one is a crucible where we can heat a metal into it. The whole solar energy has been duplicated over one particular reflector. This reflects all the energy to the crucible where the metal converted into molten state, and that can be used for a specific reason like a molding it into any part or a component. Okay. So some other thing where you tested, you know this, you do have a tower, like a single concentrated tower where the electricity has been concentrated at a particular tower, and the energy what get from that particular concentrated will be taken part to use for another many multiple uses or applications. So this is how the solar energy has been used very efficiently, which is endless to us. Thank you.